Now, moving towards the second category of your large fixed shops, which is your chain store or multiple shops. Have you ever visited Pantaloons or Max or other showrooms where you can see that, which are basically dealing in a one category basically, rather than providing wide variety, they are engaged in brand. Okay, so if we will talk about the chain store or multiple shops, these are the networks of retail store that are owned and operated by manufacturers rather than retailers. Manufacturers and intermediaries. Say who are helping the manufacturers. Okay, so it's not like that they will gonna purchase from the manufacturers will gonna purchase from some outside and after that they will gonna sell. It's just that manufacturers manufacture their own brand and after that with the different branches within different states all over the country, or apart from that, they will gonna sell that their brand as per the brand image where they are required. Okay, so these are basically operated by the manufacturer. Under this type of arrangement, a number of shops, as I told you, with the similar appearance as we took the example of Pantaloons, where you can find a variety of clothes, whether it is your ladies garment or your gents garment or kids garment, you can find all the variety of the same brand which named as Pantaloon, right? Okay, so or Puma, even Divas, there are so many brands which are engaged in the similar products with the similar pricing policy as well, right? Even though they are having different branches in the different places, but still they will charge the same price all over the branches. Okay, so basically they are, if we will talk about the establishment, they are established in the localities and spread over different part of countries. Which kind of locality they are in? Either the residential or workplace. Okay, so this is the difference between your chain store and departmental store, that those who are located in the central place but they are located at the either workplace or the residential place, right? Now, as I said that these organizations are basically run by the single manufacturer, so we can say that by the same organization. Even if these manufacturers are in contact with the intermediaries, these intermediaries will gonna form same organization named as the same organization who are dealing in the identical mercantile, identical mercantilization strategies. Okay, with the identical product, that is same products all over the country. So with this you can see that what the chain store mean. Now after this, let us discuss the features of the chain store. Our first feature will be, as we have discussed, that they are located in the nearby either residential or workplace localities rather than central place, right? Secondly, what will be the other feature of your chain store? If we will talk about the management of the chain store, they are centralized by the head office. As we have discussed that it is the manufacturer or the intermediary of the basically the same organization which are operating at large scale in different parts of the country, right? So this is a particular office named as the head office, and that is centralized by the head office. Whatever the strategies to be used, how whatever the products to be distributed, what will be the brand, so all decisions are of the different organizations of the different in the different part of the country are taken by the head office, and that is why it is centralized by the head office. Thirdly, these all branches are headed by all branches. Okay, we are talking about branches now. These branches. So these branches are headed by the branch manager, who is responsible for all the activities done on day-to-day basis, whatever the report on the daily basis he will form. He is required to submit, to send the report to the head office regarding whatever the cash he had deposited, how much the sale was made, what are the requirement of the stock. So all the reports are to be sent to the head office, but responsibility is given to the branch manager. Your next one is basically your chain store being located at some other places, but being engaged in the large scale activities, they trade on only on cash basis. Yes, you can do even payment by the credit card banks as well, but basically they made payment, basically they are engaged in the operations on the cash basis. Okay, and fifth one is whatever the cash they will receive, they are supposed to send that cash, to submit that cash into the bank. Okay, so now coming toward the next one is even all the branches, if we'll talk about the branches are controlled by head office. Whatever the policies the head office will gonna frame, these all branches are supposed to be controlled as per those policies only. Okay, and the last one is basically these head office, as if they cannot go to all the parts, thus what they do is they appoint inspector for all the branches, who will take care, who will supervise the day-to-day functioning of all the departments, and also check out the quality, whether whatever the manufacturer is sending in between, if any of the fraud will happen and they will gonna send poor quality. Thus the inspector will take care of all those operations, that whether the right quality is providing to the consumers or not. Okay, so friend, these are the features. Now coming towards the merits of your chain store. So friends, after the discussion about the chain store and its features, what are the advantages of chain store as per you? First of all, as if these chain store we have discussed that deals on the cash basis, so it's obvious that there is no chances of bad debts. Secondly, as if we have discussed that they are operated directly by the manufacturers, thus there is elimination of middleman, as they are in direct contact with the manufacturers, and whatever the organization is performing the activity, they will be in direct contact with the manufacturers, and thus there is elimination of middleman. Okay, thirdly, there is economies of scale, as if not only the elimination of middleman, not only the saving of the bad debts, but apart from that they are engaged in the direct dealing, and thus even though they are operating at large scale, whatever the profit they will gonna share with the other agents, other middlemen, they will be saved, right? And thus, as if they are engaged in the multiple shops. See, in case few of the products are not required here, they can send that product to some other place, right? So this is how they will save the lost items as well. So thus they play economies of scale. Fourthly, as if we have discussed that they can transfer the goods. So there is a transfer of good. Whatever the taste of the particular area has been changed, those can be the taste of the other area, right? So they can send, they can transfer those goods to the demanding area. Okay. After this, fifth one is low cost. As there is no such operating cost which they are required to spend on the operation of the business, which were required in case of departmental store, as if there were lot of consumer services which they were supposed to provide to their consumers. So they are not supposed to provide such services, and thus and as well eliminating the middleman also. So there are so many reasons that they are able to save the cost, and thus the cost will become low. Okay. Next one is flexibility. How they are flexible? See, as if we have discussed that demand of the taste of the consumer will goes on change, right? So they will be able to transfer those goods and to change the inventory with the new one which is demanded by the consumer. Thus they provide flexibility. And lastly, diffusion of risk. By sending the non-demanding to the demanding area, they will be able to cover up such losses, right? And thus the risk will be eliminated, basically the risk will be diffused, and thus these are the advantages of the chain store. Now after this, coming toward the disadvantages of a chain store. So friends, after the advantages, what are the disadvantages of your chain store? First of all, just like your departmental store, here also there is lack of personal touch as if head office is one but operating at different parts of the countries, and contacting to each department consumers is not easy, and thus there is a lack of personal touch. Secondly, there is difficult to change demand. See, your consumer is king. Whatever the consumer want, he will gonna buy only as per his needs, and thus the demand of those consumer cannot be changed. It's only the products which you are supposed to change as per the demand. So one cannot change the demand, but one can change the products only. Thus there are chances of losses, right? Thirdly, lack of initiative. See, being head office is the owner and provided responsibility to different branch managers, right? Thus, as if those branch managers are liable only to get the regular salary, regular income, right? And thus, whatever the loss will gonna incur, it will be incurred by only the head office. Thus, being rewarded by the regular salary, they will not gonna take initiatives to raise the sale, as if the profit is not there, it's the head office profit. Thus, there is lack of initiatives taken by the branch managers and other staff members. The next disadvantage of the chain store is limited selection of goods, which means, as if we already discussed that in case of chain store, they are engaged in identical product, right? They are not providing wide variety of product under a single roof. Thus, one can select only limited group goods from one chain store, right? As if we'll talk about pantaloons, they are offering only few variety. you might not be able to find your taste over there. So it's all upon the consumer what they want. So there is limited selection of goods in case of chain stores. Okay, so friends, these are all about your multiple shops and the chain store we have discussed regarding the definition, features, advantages and disadvantages of these multiple shops. Okay, so hope you guys learned the concept till now. For the further classes, please download our app Scholars Learning. In our next class, we are going to learn regarding the difference between your chain store and departmental store, which is very important as per your examination point of view. But to learn that difference, it's obvious you should be aware about the features and the merits and demerits and the definition of both departmental store as well as the chain store, right? And for those, you are required these classes, and thus the sequential studies is necessary. And for that, you are required to download our app Scholars Learning. And in case you have already downloaded our app, hope you guys gonna like our classes more and more. Okay, thank you.